Hey there, Jed Corbinus here from JedCorbinus.com, and welcome to Talk Therapy. It has been a while. Been doing Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. It was Memorial Day weekend. Thank you to all the troops. Thank you to all the troops all around the world, from all countries, from all everything. I mean, anybody who sacrifices anything, especially to protect our freedom here in the United States of America, but any troops throughout the world who sacrifice their lives, that's important to me. So, of course, you don't do something for a while and now my mind is scattered. It is all over the place. It is just, my analytical mind is like really wreaked havoc on my brain. Because I haven't shut it down. I've been listening to it for the last how many days, and now it's just gotten the best of me, which is why I do this every day. And it's gonna shut down. Like I have this calling right now, and hopefully it keeps going and going and going. But this calling right now is the fact that there are so many people out there who have as much passion as I do, who have probably, you know, bigger followings or whatever than me, but they just aren't breaking through. So today, or I just have this idea of syndication. So I'll be sharing some stuff to my social media sites from other people because I'm syndicating with them, so they'll be doing the same thing for me, sharing my content to their social media, to their social, and it's just really pulling me into doing that right now. Because that just shows two things. One, you're validating somebody else saying this person is worthy of your time. And two, it will introduce you to a new person, right? And that's okay. Because too many people are afraid of inviting somebody in. And I'm a little bit on a soapbox for right now, but it's because I gotta shut down my analytical mind, right? Talk therapy, that's what this does. It just completely shuts down my analytical mind to say, oh my gosh, don't say the wrong thing. That's what my ego, my analytical mind always tells me. I will do it tomorrow. Don't say the wrong thing. And you're not doing the right thing. So I shut it down by just talking, by just letting it out there. So that's the syndication is what it's called. Basically for other healthcare professionals or health and wellness professionals or anybody just with a good solid foundation for health and wellness that has some inspiration, right? But yeah, it's been rough, right? Rough 8-hour drive yesterday. Whoa. Like, can't imagine being an over-the-road truck driver. You guys are amazing. Because when do you get your steps in? When do you move? Or even an office person who has to just sit all day. When do you get your steps in? Again, when do you move? Wow, you know? You can get your sit-stand desk march in place while you're working. But are you really getting it done? Because that's multitasking. And we all know, we all know humans, we don't multitask very well. Some people say they do, but our brains just aren't designed for that. So then what, right? Where do you get your steps in? You go home, you're already tired, you watch more TV, or you sit on your phone, whatever it is. And I'm not outside of any of this. I used to do this. I used to be in the office. Now I'm physiology, right? Exercise physiologist in the clinic. And I go out on the floor all the time and walking and get my steps in. But that's not where I stop, right? I go home, I make sure I get 10,000 steps. I love the fact that I've been doing that. Now, I think the reason I'm compelled to say anything at all right now is because yesterday I missed my 10,000 steps. And I'm really bummed about that. I think that's why I woke up late this morning. I think I'm beating myself up a little bit because of that. And I think I'm over it now. Actually, I know I'm over it now. Because yesterday is yesterday. Whatever we chose to do or chose not to do is yesterday. So I'm over it. So we move on. We choose today. You get those 10,000 steps in, no matter what. And you make that healthy food choice. You grab those vegetables. Oh my gosh, vegetables, right? How bad do you want it? I'm asking myself this right now. I'm literally asking myself, how bad do I want it? Whatever it is. How bad do I want it? It, for me, the definition of it is walking outside my door and having my gym. Yep. Working in my own gym on my own time, creating WODs. People pay me to create workouts of the day, either specifically for them or for their company. And then having clients come to my gym, and then I have people teaching what they want to teach in that gym. There's education happening. I mean, why not? Why can't it happen? And it will. And it has. But the thing is working towards the dream, or the exercise dream, the plan, working towards the plan is what is the best part, right? Because as soon as you achieve it, then what? Then what, right? Then you get to enjoy it. Okay. I'm already there. I'm already enjoying it. And that's the process, right? Thinking of something that you want to do so much, then obsessing about it, then in your mind you already went to it, you've already had it, now you're done with it. Now you move on to the next thing. The coolest part is then it starts to happen. As soon as you let it go in your mind, you're like, yeah, great, I've already been there, done that. Then it actually happens in your life. Like, not many people understand that. If you don't, look up Kyle Cease. He explains it 100 times better than I can. It's amazing. And not a lot of people even realize what this can do for you. You start saying, I've already owned a gym in my life. Now what can I do? That gym is gonna come. You're gonna do it. You just have to obsess about it so much, think about it so much, do it in your mind over and over and over and over again, and then it'll happen. And then you're gonna ask, then what? Doing it right now. I'm literally doing it right now, being an exercise physiologist in this clinic. Because I've already predicted the entire thing. I've predicted the entire thing. Now, has it happened exactly how I predicted? No, but that doesn't matter. Like, I'm about 95% correct. all I did was say it out loud to say, this is what happened. Right? May 30th, 2017. This is what happened. People started to share my content. I started to share their content. And that day really changed all of that person's life. It's amazing. It is amazing. And you just have to believe it. It started to come out of the woodwork. You go, what is this? Who is this? What are you doing? How does that work? That's it. I slept in this morning, which is crazy to me, because I wanted to break a pattern and then create a new one. A pattern, not a habit, right? Like, just breaking a pattern right now. Because I think that's what it's about, is finding the pattern and then changing it. Creating another pattern and then changing it. And loving the unknown and loving the change. Do I know? I don't know. I don't know if that's gonna work, but what's working right now? No idea. I love it. It's crazy to me to think that there's people just going through life, waking up, hurry up, go to work, hurry up, be done with work, hurry up, go home, hurry up, eat some supper, hurry up, watch the TV, hurry up, go to bed, hurry up, wake up, hurry up, go to work, hurry up, come home, hurry up, eat some supper, hurry up, watch some TV, hurry up, go to bed, and they do that over and over and over again. That's what's crazy to me. You've now become a robot. And change. You have suffocated change. How about suffocate your normal patterns and invite change? And breathe in change. Right? Take a deep breath right now, intentionally. You've just interrupted a pattern. Build on that. Can you imagine the possibilities? Because you just changed a pattern. How did you change a pattern? Because you would have never taken a deep breath like that. What else can you do intentionally? Possibilities are endless when you start to realize, when you start to increase your awareness of your everyday patterns, of your reactions to things, instead of being aware of them. I'm only talking to myself. I'm reassuring the fact that this is right. This is right. Shut down the analytical mind. Shut down your ego. The voice that's always telling you right or wrong, good or bad. Follow this. Get there. And I'm literally talking to myself saying, you'll get there. And you too. So as always, if you're willing to change from the neck up, you will change from the neck down. I believe in you. Now it's your turn. Start believing yourself. Stay safe out there. Be blessed. Bye for now.